Do you sometimes miss the old feature on uploading your web resources where you are able to just type in the code? I've got good news for you. It is now back when you upload a web resource to your solution. Hi everyone, welcome back to my Power Platform tutorial series. I'm Tiyani, and today I'm going to show you a feature which Microsoft previously removed on Power Platform when you try to upload a web resource, the ability to edit code directly on the upload side pane. Before we jump in, hit that subscribe button, smash the thumbs up button, and share your thoughts in the comment section down below. Your support helps keep this content coming. Now let's get started. Head over to the Maker portal. As you can see, I already have a solution created, new web resource experience. Click on new. Scroll down to more. Web resource. And now you will see that you have a new section here called code, where you are able to type in the code that you want or paste it. For instance, I have code in VS Code that I want to test out. And here is the code. It is just a simple JavaScript method, which I'm going to just select, copy. And when I go back to the new experience for uploading a web resource, I'm going to paste it and allows me to change the file type, whether it is JavaScript, CSS, XML, or HTML. Mind you, this feature is limited for pasting code, meaning that for data and images, it does not work. As you can see, when I select data, it removes that text box where I pasted my code. And same goes for images. But when I go back to JavaScript, you'll see that the text box for typing code, it is back. And we can continue to give it a name. I'm going to call this one test.js. The display name, I'm just going to copy the name to test.js and click on save. And now it is added to our solution. And you can update the code without you uploading a new file. On our JavaScript web resource, click on the ellipsis, click edit. You will notice that the code section is there and I'm able to add new comments to the same code that I uploaded earlier and click on save. And just like that, we're back on the game with a feature that Microsoft previously removed. If you like this content, check out this video up here for customizing the app header icon. And I'll see you in the next one. If you've enjoyed this in-depth walk, give us a like, share your thoughts in the comment section, and don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.